I have a banner that needs grommets added. It helps to have marks showing where the grommets go, but making the marks and getting them spaced equally is a pain. I have a script for Illustrator that helps. See the link in the description. But this job is in Photoshop, so I rewrote the script to make another version of it. Grommet Marks Photoshop. I'll show the script in Windows. It works the same on Mac OS. To start, I'll make a solid fill layer, plain white, so you can see the results better. To run the script, open the Actions panel. I already have an action to run the script. For help adding scripts to Photoshop, see the link in the description for another video that shows the steps. In the Actions list, select Grommet Marks Photoshop. Click the Actions panel Play button. First are the choices to add marks along the top and left edges. Click the checkbox to enable either or both. The options for top and left are identical. The only difference is which edge the marks are drawn. Start with where to place the first grommet mark. This is the distance from the top left of the image. X is the distance across, and Y is the distance down, where the first mark is centered. Next is how to distribute the marks. There are two ways to do this. First is the number of marks to add. The value entered is the precise number of marks, which are spaced equally across the edge. The second way is to enter the desired spacing. The distance won't match this value exactly. It will be the closest value and number of marks that keeps them spaced equally across the edge. Use whichever method suits you best. Left edge works the same. Then for both top and left, there is the option to mirror the same along the opposing edge. The next section begins with measurement units. This applies to the X and Y values entered above and the mark size entered next. Mark shape can be either round or square. The mark's layer may be an existing layer chosen in the list or create the layer grommet marks. The marks may be filled or stroked or both. Click the checkbox to enable each as desired. The color of the fill and stroke may vary. Click the colored buttons to the right of each to open the color picker. If the marks have a stroke, enter the weight in points. The final section is settings, to save and reuse the options currently set. I'll start with default values, except increase the size so the marks show better. 1/4 inch should do. Click OK, and the script gets to work. And there are 10 grommet marks along the top edge. I'll run the script again, but this time make it 5 marks. Running the script a second time doesn't add more marks. It starts over by removing the current marks and adding them again. But this only works if the default grommet marks is the choice for layer each time. If marks are added to another layer, they will remain. So keep that in mind. There is also undo, or use the history panel to step back. Now let's try preferred spacing instead. That might be too many grommets. I'll increase the distance. That's better. Our banner needs the same marks along the bottom. Enable the option, and there you go. Left and right would be good too. But this art isn't very tall, so I'll set left to 3 marks and mirror that on the right. That looks good. Last, make the marks smaller, no bigger than a grommet, so once added over the marks are gone. 1/8 inch should do. And finally, delete the solid fill layer. That was just to aid this demonstration. Now the job is ready to output, and Bindery has a guide of where to put grommets in the finished banner. Depending on the content, use a color for the marks that works. If dark, use white dots, for example. You get the idea. Like this video if you found it helpful, and subscribe so you're notified of future videos. Also, leave a comment. I always like to hear from you. All feedback is welcome. There are plenty of other scripts and videos for them. Click the video or playlist on screen for more. Thank you for watching.